All Academy, always with you.
The first question in Part C, that is in Mechanical Engineering stream, is the standard covering design, development, production and installation is. The right answer is option 2, that is ISO 9001. So what is this ISO? ISO is a International Organization for Standardization, which gives some set of rules or guidelines to the various companies to maintain a quality of business. Over 1 million companies and organizations in 170 countries are certified by ISO 9001. So the standard covering design and development and production and installation in which the ISO 9001 guidelines are followed. The next question is, the type of losses occurs due to the reduction in the efficiency of a worker is. The right answer is option 3, that is indirect losses. So indirect losses are the losses which occurs in the production or in any organization due to the less efficiency or reduction in the efficiency of a worker. Then such a losses are known as indirect losses. The next question is, the unit of lathe which houses the lathe spindle and control levers for a speed selection is called. The right answer is option 1, that is headstock. A headstock is a non-movable device or a non-movable section which is generally at the left side of a lathe machine, and it consists of lathe spindle, gear levers as well as power on off button. The next question is, dash lathe is used for precision work on tools, dies and gauges. The right answer is option 3, that is tool room lathe. A tool room lathe is generally a high precision lathe having a gearbox in the headstock offering extended range of thread pitches and feeds. It is used for making a precision component in a tool room. Thus, the lathe is known as tool room lathe. The next question is, the square or irregular shaped workpiece for turning is usually mounted in. The right answer is option 4, that is independent chuck. So independent chuck consists of 4 jaws which will help to hold a irregular shaped workpiece in a strong manner or in a strong hold. Thus, the irregular shaped workpiece and or a square shaped workpiece are mounted or in a independent chuck. And the next question is, the operation of finishing and sizing hole which has been previously drilled is. The right answer is option 1, that is reaming. A reaming is a cutting operation with a multi-edged cutting tool which is constantly in action. The tool used for reaming process is called reaming tool, which slightly enlarges the pre-existing or previously drilled hole to a tightly toleranced diameter. So the reaming is used for finishing and sizing of holes which are previously drilled. And the next question is, the size of a shaper is usually specified by. The right answer is option 2, that is length of a stroke. The size of a shaper depends on the maximum length of a stroke which it can take. Generally, for a horizontal shaper, it is almost from 16 inch to 24 inch long. So the size of a shaper or a shaping machine is usually specified by length of stroke. And the next question is, the arbor of a milling machine is used to hold. The right answer is option 1, that is cutting tool or a milling tool which is mounted on a arbor in a milling machine. The next question is, the process of changing the shape of a worn out grinding wheel to original shape is called. The right answer is truing. A truing is a process in which the worn out grinding wheels are changed into original shape. It is nothing but reshaping or recreating the original shape of a grinding wheel. So that is called truing. The next question is, a control system code used for generating the circular interpolation clockwise in CNC machine is. The right answer is option 2, that is G02 code is used to generate a circular interpolation in a clockwise direction. A translation of linear axis positions into curved tool motion is called circular interpolation. The G01 code is used for linear interpolation. G02 code is used for circular interpolation in a clockwise direction, whereas G03 interpolation is used for a counterclockwise direction. The next question is, the principle of erosion of a metal by interrupted electric spark discharge between the tool and workpiece is used in, the right answer is option 1, that is electric discharge machining. So electric discharge machining is a non-traditional machining process in which the material is removed from the workpiece with the help of a thermal energy in terms of spark. The next question is, the process of removal of metal by controlled dissolution of an anode of an electrolytic cell in dash machining. The right answer is option 2, that is ECM. The ECM refers to electrochemical machining, which is a non-traditional machining method in which the electrochemical process is used to remove a material from the workpiece. And the next question is, it is a taper allowed on a vertical surface of a pattern for easy removal of a pattern without damaging the cavity surface. The right answer is option 4, that is draft allowance. So draft or taper allowance is given to all the surface perpendicular to parting line. The draft allowance is given to the pattern so that it can be easily removed from the mold without damaging the mold cavity. The next question is, the property of a sand to flow to all the portion of a mold is, the right answer is option 2, that is flowability. So flowability is a property of a sand mix which influences the production of a molds of a uniform hardness and density and consequently without creating any damages or defects in a mold. So that is a flowability. And the next question is, the precision casting process which does not require a machining is, the right answer is option 3, that is investment molding. So in investment molding, once the product is done, so it does not require any machining process. So it is a precision casting process in which the machining is not required, that is investment molding. And the next question is, the sand used to separate the cope and drag surface is, the right answer is option 3, that is parting sand. So the parting sand is used to separate the cope and drag surface. So parting sand is used to prevent the sticking of a green sand on a pattern, and also it allows the sand on a parting surface of a cope and drag to separate without cleaning. And the next question is, which of the following gas flame has an excess of acetylene? The right answer is option 2, that is carburizing flame. So a carburizing flame is produced when there is an excess amount of acetylene gas for an amount of oxygen being consumed in an oxyacetylene mixture. So in an oxyacetylene mixture, in a gas mixture, if a excess amount of acetylene is there, then the flame produced in that mixture will be carburizing flame. The next question is, in which of the following resistance welding process the continuous weld is produced? The right answer is option 3, that is seam welding. In seam welding, the continuous weld is produced. A seam welding is a joining process of a workpiece made of similar or dissimilar materials along a continuous seam. So that is a continuous welding is seen in the seam welding process. The next question is, the consumable wire electrode is used in, the right answer is option 1, that is MIG welding. So in MIG welding, we use a consumable wire electrode. So MIG welding is a process in which the continuous solid wire electrode is fed through a welding gun and onto the weld pool, joining the two base materials together. The consumable electrode is a filler material or a metal welding rod which contains the flux that contributes to the producing a barrier to protect the weld from any contamination. So the consumable wire electrodes are used in a MIG welding. The next question is, the process of cutting the extra metal in a workpiece is called? The right answer is option 4, that is trimming. A trimming is a cutting operation performed on a formed parts to remove the excess metal to maintain the actual size. So trimming is a process to remove the excess or extra material on a workpiece. And the next question is, in forging, the process of increasing the length of a bar at the expense of its thickness is? The right answer is option 2, that is drawing down. So drawing is a metal working process which uses the tensile force to stretch the metal, glass or a plastic. As the metal is drawn or pulled, it is stretched stretched into thinner surface. So this drawing process is classified into two types. One is sheet metal drawing and another one is a wire or bar or tube drawing. And the next question is, the metal is forced by a high pressure through an orifice to get the desired form in a. The right answer is option 3, that is extrusion. So the extrusion is a metal forming process in which the metal or a workpiece is forced to flow through a die or a orifice to reduce its cross section to convert into some desired shape. And the next question is, when both mass and energy is allowed to cross the boundary of a system, it is called? The right answer is option 2, that is open system. So these thermodynamic systems are classified into three types. One is open system, closed system and isolated system. In open system, both energy as well as mass crosses the system boundary. Whereas in closed system, only energy will cross the system boundary, but mass does not cross the system boundary. Whereas in isolated system, both energy as well as mass does not cross the system boundary. So these are the three types of system boundary. So the mass and energy is allowed, both will come out from the system boundary in open system. The next question is, which of the following is an intensive property? So intensive property means which are independent of mass. So the right answer is option 1, that is temperature. So the temperature is independent of mass. So this temperature does not depend on mass. So it is a intensive property. The next question is, the state of a substance whose evaporation from its liquid state is complete. The right answer is option 4, that is perfect gas. So what is this perfect gas? Perfect gas or ideal gas, both are the same. Okay. It is a gas that acts according to the idealized relationship between volume, pressure and temperature. So in perfect gas models, the intermolecular force are neglected. So
click on subscribe button and press the bell icon to get updates from All Academy.